Good morning, everyone. This is Rob McDougall from Zhang Financial here with your economic update. Today is Monday, November 25th, 2024. So last week, in terms of economic data that was released, as we previewed, very light, very real estate, home heavy, and slightly on the negative side. But as you'll see, expectations for fourth quarter GDP growth, still very strong. So starting off last week, Tuesday, building permits, housing start, both of those metrics came in just slightly below consensus. On Thursday, then, we had existing home sales, which also fell just slightly short of consensus. All three were very close. So nothing really to take away from that. Initial jobless claims, that actually came in better than expected. So expectation was 220,000 new jobless claims the week before, came in at 213,000. So that was positive. A slight negative on the week, the Michigan Consumer Sentiment Index, which came out on Friday, that is for November. The expectation was 73.7, came in somewhat significantly below at 71.8. So that was it in terms of the economic data that was released last week. The Atlanta Federal Reserve took those metrics into their update. In terms of their expectations for fourth quarter GDP growth for the United States, they actually took it up slightly. So a week before it had been at positive 2.5, they upped that slightly to positive 2.6%. Inflation expectations hardly moved last week. It's really flatlined last couple of weeks. So that currently is at 2.34% expectations for inflation for the next 10 years. Terms of expectations for rate cuts, this keeps coming down. So there's a December meeting, and the expectation just a couple of weeks ago, well over 70% expectation of a rate cut. Last week, we reported the fact that it was at about 65%. That's now down to right about 51%. So pretty much a coin flip as to whether or not the Federal Reserve is going to take another interest rate cut in December. Some of the language that we've heard from Chairman Jerome Powell and other Fed representatives kind of suggests they probably won't, but we'll see. So let's take a look at how the markets responded to that sparse economic data last week. Now, prior week, we told you it was a rough one. We gave up a lot of the gains post the Trump election. Well, last week, we got some of that back. So S&P up nicely last week. S&P 500 up 1.7%. What really led the U.S. markets? Growth, but not large cap. Small cap growth. I think this is the first time I mentioned this in at least a year. So small cap growth actually led U.S. markets. Very interesting. On a year-to-date basis now, the S&P 500, and I think this is close to its high again, up 26.7%, led by large cap growth. In terms of international markets, pretty much flat last week. The developed markets ex-U.S. up 29 basis points, emerging markets up 21. However, that was in the face of another downtick in China. I think this is a third week in a row. Pretty rough results. China equity markets down 1.83%. For the year now, China up 12.5%. Just 3 weeks ago, China was at the heels of the S&P 500 in terms of year-to-date return, and that's rolled over pretty hard. Lastly, fixed income last week. Last week, fixed income, we use a Bloomberg U.S., aggregate bond index, that was up slightly. It was up 0.19%. We had the two-year yield up 5%, but the 10-year dropped 3 basis points. So on a year-to-date basis, bonds, Bloomberg U.S. aggregate bond index, up 1.5%. Long-term bonds, however, which we don't use in our portfolios, but just for reference, long-term bonds here in the U.S., government bonds, down 4.5% year-to-date. So this week, in terms of economic data that will be released, there really is not much. Shortened week, holiday. Tuesday, new home sales, nothing there. It's expected to be slightly down from the September number. That'll be the October reading. Wednesday, though, we do get some fairly significant information, particularly on inflation. PCE, the index, the inflation index that the Federal Reserve relies most heavily upon, both the core headline number will come out. Both of those numbers expected to be flat from the month of September. So for October, PCE headline number expected to be at 0.2%, and core PCE expected to be at 0.3% month over month. Now, a positive expectation for Wednesday, durable goods orders. In the month of September, those were down negative, down 7.7%, expected to be at 0.1% for October. Personal income expected to be exactly in line month of October. Month of September was up 0.3, expected to be at 0.3 again. Personal spending, now that's expected to decelerate a little bit. That's not a bad thing for inflation. For the month of September, personal spending month over month was up 0.5%. For the month of October, that's expected to come in positive 0.4%. And initial jobless claims will be reported, as always, a day early, usually reported on Thursday, will be reported on Wednesday. Expectation is a slight uptick from that abnormally, apparently, low 213,000, expected to come in at 217,000. So that's it for a recap of last week, a preview of this week, and a look at the markets last week. Thank you very much for attending. We hope you have a great holiday celebration, Thanksgiving, and we'll look forward to seeing you next week. Thank you very much.